In these two examples, we're given the graph of a blue function, and then we're given the function value, and it's our job to determine the input. So for this first example, we're given that f of x equals negative 2, and we're asked to determine what x would be. So negative 2 is our output. Remember, the output is a y value, so this tells us that y is equal to negative 2. We want to know what x would have to be, or what the input would have to be. So if we go over to our graph and locate y equals negative 2, which is here, and go over to our function, we can see what x would have to be. We can see that x would have to be negative 3 if y is equal to negative 2. So again, what we found is that f of negative 3 is equal to negative 2. When the input is negative 3, the function value or the output is negative 2, which does correspond to the point negative 3, negative 2. Looking at the second example, we're given f of x equals 1. So the function value is equal to 1, which means y is equal to 1. We want to determine what x would have to be, or the input would have to be, when y is equal to 1. So again, if we go to the y-axis, locate 1 here, go over to our function, we can see that when y is equal to 1, x would have to be 2. So we have x equals 2, which again means f of 2 equals 1, which would correspond to the point with an x coordinate of 2 and a y coordinate of 1. Okay, I hope you found this helpful.